In this video, we are going to discuss about sampling. So, in signals and systems, we are going to hear some words like signal frequency, sampling frequency, like this. So, what is meant by sampling and what is meant by sampling frequency and what is meant by sampling theorem? All these we are going to discuss in this class. So, sampling and sampling theorem are somewhat different. Please make a note on that words. Sampling is nothing but just converting continuous signal into discrete form. That is the process of sampling actually. So, what is meant by sampling theorem means, here we are having sampling theorem, a continuous time signal can be completely converted into its samples and can be recovered back. We can convert any continuous signal into its samples and we can recover our continuous signals from that samples back whenever we are having a condition to get that. So, whenever fs is greater than or equal to 2 fm, that means whenever sampling frequency is greater than or equal to twice the maximum frequency component of the message signal. You can see the theorem here. A continuous time signal can be completely represented into its samples and recovered back if the sampling frequency fs is greater than or equal to the twice of highest frequency component of the message signal. I want to discuss with you something about this statement. How we need to keep in mind about this statement means. So, for example, if you are having any continuous time signal like this, I am considering a sine signal. This signal we can completely represent into its samples. So, we can completely represent into its samples by multiplying pulse time. How we can convert, how we can completely convert this signal into its samples means, just by multiplying a pulse train with the frequency fs. This is the pulse train with the frequency fs. So, that means time period ts. Ts is the time period between the samples. So, by just multiplying these samples with this continuous signal, you can completely represent your continuous signal into its samples like this. Like this, you can completely represent your signal into samples. So, you are going to get this type of nature according to the samples you consider, you are going to get this. So, you are going to get the same signal shape which you are having in continuous form. That means, a continuous signal we can completely represent it in its samples. If you want to reconstruct your continuous signal, you can trace your signal here itself. You can see by this sampled signal, this is called as sampled signal. That means converted continuous signal after conversion into discrete, that is called as sampled signal. This sampled signal is in the form of continuous only, that will take the structure of continuous signal. So, and if it is in this form, then you can recover back your signal. If you want to recover back your signal, you just take the envelope of this signal, or you are having another process that I will show you in the next class, how you will reconstruct your signal. So, that means you need to consider transform of this sampled signal. After getting transform of this sampled signal, you will take a spectrum and you will take inverse transform, you are going to get your signal. So, that I will show you in the next class, how we will get spectrum of this signal and how we will reconstruct our message signal again in the derivation I will show you. So, now in the statement I given you, a continuous time signal can be completely represented into its samples. I am not converting partially, I can convert completely. Any continuous signal I can represent in its samples completely and can be recovered back also. I can recover back this signal. If I am having this sampled signal, I can recover back my original continuous message signal whenever, but to do all this process, that means to completely represent to its samples and to recover back completely, perfectly, we need to follow a condition. So, if this is the condition. If the sampling frequency is nothing but frequency of pulse train. If sampling frequency fs is greater than or equivalent to twice the maximum frequency or highest frequency component of the message signal. I want to discuss with you about the highest frequency component of message signal. For example, if you are having any message signal like this, it's having two or three components, sine 2 pi t plus sine 3 pi t plus sine 4 pi t. These are your message signal components. By observing your message signal itself, you can see your message signal is having three frequency components. That three frequency components are omega is equivalent to 2 pi. So, that means omega 1 I am considering. So, 2 pi f1 is equivalent to 2 pi. So, here your f1 is equivalent to 1 if you cancel 2 pi with 2 pi. Like that, omega 2 is equivalent to 3 pi. 2 pi f is equivalent to 3 pi. So, pi pi I am cancelling. F is equivalent to 3 by 2. 3 by 2 means 1.5. So, you can consider 1.5. So, now you are having omega 3 is equivalent to 4 pi. 2 pi f is equivalent to 4 pi. So, 2 pi with 2. F3 is equivalent to 2. So, you are having three frequency components, each of frequency 1 hertz, 1.5 hertz and 2 hertz. Now, which you can consider as frequency of your message signal? This is very important point. Which component you will consider as message frequency means whatever highest frequency component is there, that is considered as message frequency component. That means FM is equivalent to maximum of F1 comma F2 comma F3. This is F2. So, F3. So, this is equivalent to maximum of 1 or 1.52 means 2 can be considered as your FM. So, like this way you need to consider. So, as this as a basic case, so in the statement they given to construct completely to represent into its samples any continuous signal, if you want to represent in its samples completely and to recover back your sampling frequency, whatever sampling train here you are considering, that sampling frequency must be greater than or equivalent to your twice the maximum frequency component of your message signal. So, this FM is the message frequency. So, you need to consider, so this FS at least equivalent to twice this FM. So, that means, for example, what will happen if you violated this condition, that means FS less than 2 FM if you consider like that. Actually, you need to consider FS greater than or equal to 2 FM. In this least condition is FS is equivalent to 2 FM. This is called as Nyquist rate. This is also very, very important. Why? Because in so many exams, they are asking what is the Nyquist rate of the signal if message frequency is this. If highest frequency component value is 2 hertz, what may be the Nyquist rate of your signal? Is equivalent to 2 FM. 2 into 2, 4 hertz may be Nyquist rate of your signal. That means at least 4 hertz you need to consider to convert a 2 hertz signal into its discrete form. So, that is the meaning. So, here this is the Nyquist rate. If you violated this Nyquist and sampling rate, sampling theorem, that means if FS less than 2 FM, generally what will happen? I want to discuss with you the general case, practical case. So, here in these two cases, I am considering like FS is maximum. So, FS is maximum means definitely time period is minimum. If I consider frequency as maximum, as F is equivalent to 1 by T, that means reciprocal of time period, if I increased frequency, in this cases I consider maximum frequency. I am considering maximum frequency means definitely my time period will be very low. So, here you can see the time period of my samples is having a very less difference. So, like that, for example, in this case, if I am considering frequency, see sampling trend frequency as minimum. If you are considering less frequency, then your samples is having more time period. Time period between the samples is high when you are considering FS is less. If you are increasing the frequency, time period will decrease. If you are decreasing the frequency, time period will increase. That means more frequency signal is having less time period, less frequency signal is having more time period. Here less frequency signal I want to consider as my impulse train. So it's having more time period. You can see for same signal, if I consider less frequency than 2 FM, then frequency if I am going to decrease than this means you are getting high time period samples. That means like this I am considering. You can see. So you can see the difference between these two trains. This is also impulse train, but this is also impulse train. What is the difference means? Here time period is less. Time between the samples delay is less. Here rate of repeating is high. Time period is high. Time period high means frequency is less. So now if you are doing same process sampling, if you done sampling process, if you want to apply this theorem, that means you can convert any signal into its samples and can be recovered back. That point if you want to see there. So just sampling is nothing but multiplying signal with pulse train. You are going to get discrete. So here I am multiplying, here I am getting some value, and here I am multiplying with this, I got some value, and here I multiplied something, I got this value. And here I am not having anything, so 0. So like this if I got. Are you getting your actual signal structure? The envelope of this sampled signal is having this nature? No, it's not having. If you want to reconstruct, if you consider the envelope of this signal, how it seems to be? It seems to be like this. But this is not your actual signal. This is not your actual signal, you can see. But here if you consider the envelope of the signal, that is exactly equivalent to your message signal. That means from this itself you can recover your signal. But here from this can you recover back? You can't recover back. That's what your sampling theorem is stating. That means so any continuous signal can be completely represent to its samples and can be recovered back whenever your sampling frequency is greater than or equivalent to 2 FM, at least is equivalent to 2 FM, Nyquist rate you need to consider, where FM is equivalent to maximum frequency component in the message signal. Your message signal may have so many frequency components where FM is equivalent to maximum of all that frequency components. So this is about sampling theorem. In the next class we are going to get the proof for sampling theorem. That means we are going to verify the sampling theorem in the next class itself.